Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian, Crafting. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm coming to share with you my large journal. I started this journal, I think, last year. It's already a really long time when I started this this journal. And then I placed it on the side because I wasn't sure what I actually want to create like next. So I placed it on the side, but I finally finished up. It has already new owner. This journal, it's probably already with new owner, so I hope that new owner will like it, what I have created here. I found myself that the most enjoyable time I do have when I do create something from book pages and from envelopes. If you know my style, you know I'm using envelopes everywhere. And I love to do those multi-opening pockets, so in this journal you will see quite a lot. There is a tutorial for this journal. I made it long time ago. You can open like this. I made it long time ago, and it's pocket here. I can leave it there. Here I will place this new tag. So if you would like to create something like this, I will try to put links down below for this journal, for tutorial for this journal. It was, that base was made from envelopes and from, from envelopes and book pages, that basic. And I use loads of different types of embellishments like this white embossing embellishment, which I really like. I will have to make for myself some notes to, you know, to remember the things I really love to add to my journals, like this white embossing effect or cutting large images. Now I can see that. See, like this one. I really love that piece. It looks amazing. It makes beautiful decoration, and it's still, you know, still is here space for writing. So if you will need to make some important note to make it on piece like this, then you will remember. Oh, and this one, I do have something, maybe number for someone who you like, or so, you know. So I will have to make some note for myself, because sometimes I forget what I really like to add to my journals. And here we've got opening here and here. And I really like this this book page, so I left it unglued with any other layers, or untouched with any other layers. So we've got few mini tags. Here is opening down and up for some small notes, and it's pocket behind with this emboss tag and photography. This can be open and move down, and we've got teeny meeny again. See, just stamped, cut out, and it's a really beautiful embellishment. It's like very cute something. You don't even have to use it in your journal. You can just place it on the side, but it's something a little bit more than blank pages. And it's, I know it makes me happy, so I hope that new owner will feel same. That those bits and pieces, here a large pocket, are making our journals interesting. Like, it's always something to discover in those journals. And this is like holder, like small clipboard. Here I do have, these are like photo mats, so any kind of photographies can be placed there. Here is pocket, and here is pocket. So I'm holding all those photo mats with this tag. And here we've got so many pockets, not so many, we've got another pocket. And here I just added this report card, this beautiful cabinet card, few embellishments, oops, looks like this. And here just quote. Lately I love to use quotes in my journals, those motivating quotes. There is not enough to have them around. We all struggle with something sometimes, you know, and it's good to read something positive or motivating like this. It's beautiful stamp, this one. It's a really beautiful stamp. And here is pocket. And again, here I use that white embossing effect, and I really like that. Here is another magnetic pocket or closure for pocket. And I do have here, this is just collage from papers I have created with teeny mini tacks. And here another multi-openings, so it's space like this. Here we've got space maybe for photography, tack here and space behind. And I didn't glue these mini clipboard holders on all space. I glue it just here in that holder, and it's like holder for that photography. And it's space for writing here and space for writing on that other side. And as you can see, I used all kind of my offcuts leftovers, and I did like a collage from those offcuts and leftovers. And here we've got, I'm gonna slide it out. Yes. Oh, so here is another holder for this vintage tag. This is just like decoration with those stones, crystal stones. Here I do have this ephemera, another quote, and teeny mini Polaroid frame. I love them so much. They look amazing. I never had Polaroid camera, but I would like to see that. I would like to see that that effect. And this is from that proper vintage, proper old antique ledger book. So this is from 1958. Here you've got 1958. So you can even read that, those informations, those notes. I'm gonna slide it back. And these are pockets, so you can put something in those pockets. Here we've got this ephemera. And it's pocket here. I don't have any small tag, do I? I don't. Just bear with me, I will find something. Here, notes. So it can be placed there. And here we've got this. I've got another. Bear with me, I'm gonna find another one. To do. Here we've got to do. I'm gonna slide it behind. Okay. And this ephemera and just this, you know, distressed piece of paper. We've got pocket here with tack. And those beautiful book pages. They are really gorgeous. I love this print. It's a very beautiful. You don't see prints like this anymore in books. Not too much. Sometimes. Maybe in kids' books, you know, like decoration. Not in or adult books, and I think it's too shame don't have it. And we've got pocket here. I haven't placed anything in that pocket. It's ready for saving memories, maybe some tickets, notes, slide behind. Poof. And here is writing section. There is few those writing sections. I even saw papers together to make it more interesting, you know, that whoa, what is this one, that wow moment. So we've got different types of papers, grid paper, linen paper, ledger paper, here again sewn together, here a ledger paper, this is from Czech Republic, so papers sewn together. Here we've got this frame with butterfly. I love those embellishments, they are very interesting to look at. Here we've got pocket, and in that pocket we've got butterfly and just tickets. And go slide inside. Oops. Oops. So, butterfly and slide it in. And there are like spots behind, and in those spots I've got those tags. And we've got just embellishment here, and again writing paper. Here is another writing space, and I've got pocket here with this tag. Oh, upside down this. Upside down. Large pocket here, and in that pocket we've got this one. Another file folder made from that ledger book. and cabinet card and some ephemera. It's holding with this paper clip. Come on, go, go, go. And it's pocket here. And here you can see that was my trying to to coffee dye without dipping papers. I try just splash the coffee over it. And I can say, especially this, I made with my mug of coffee or from coffee. So I spill a little bit of coffee here and then I dip it here. It was, I mean, not in that book, it was separate paper. But it was so much fun, really. I was concentrating so much. I start to remember when we've been coloring with watercolors at school, how much I was concentrated at that time. And it was exactly the same. I felt like a small child again when I did that dipping with my mug to that coffee. So again, writing papers. And as you can see, there is a huge selection of different styles of papers. So, I'm gonna move it where we've got end. Oops. And here we've got another. This is my just layout. Here I did enjoy different types of dyes I do have. I use that rusty effect patina I've got here. And I used England map in the background. This is Edward John Ayer. He was traveler, tourist. Here is small information about this guy. And from that other side, it's just, you know, gluing paper. Just layout. This is really like just like decoration. I use those clock faces in that in that background. So it's really like decoration. It can be used like bookmark. It can peek out from that book like bookmark. And here we've got large pocket. I've got another pardon me, another clipboard here like this. And again, just layouts with photographies, writing space. It looks like this, so it's slide behind. And from that other side, it's opening and pocket here. I'm gonna clip it back. This paper clip. And writing paper. And here we've got another section with those multi pockets. And embossed tag, again, some layout. I think that book page in the middle, yeah, it's altered book page from horoscopes book from last year, I think. It was horoscope book I have here. So I start to alter those pages because that horoscope book is not functional anymore because it was for last year. So I have to use it somewhere. And we've got in that those pockets, we've got again those tags here and on the top as well. So they've got window here so you can see through. Again, writing space, but this one can be opened this way. And we've got, oh, I have to move it. We've got tags like this here and that top one is same. Slide it in. And it's pocket behind, and there I've got just this divider, bingo card, and this beautiful specimen card. And it's pocket on the top, and I've got just teeny, meeny, small pocket-like divider, or a file folder. And here we've got just small pocket layout. I think if you saw that tutorial, you remember how much I was struggling with this one, how I had to cut it. To make it workable, or you know, to see that this can be moved. It when I did this one, I was thinking, oh, it's like that, you know, that glass which makes lupa. In my language, it's lupa. I don't remember if is it the same in English. The glass which makes writing a bigger. You can see through that. Those images in bigger size. I should Google before I'm taking video. I should Google all those words because then I feel like, oh, Evie, you're so stupid. But in my language, it's lupa glass, which makes images bigger. So here we've got those ephemeras. And here in this pocket, I've got another layout. It looks like this. It has few tags like embellishments, you know, something hanging around. So it's frame here. From which side? From this side, yeah. From this side, you can slide there a new picture. It's teeny mini ephemera here. When we open it, we've got writing space here. It's pocket behind. And there is just this book tag, book page tag. And from that other side is this one. I'm not sure if that can be open. No, it's just layout. Oh, no. It can be open. I forgot. It's locked in when I did it. So here is another layout from my leftovers. And I really love to do those layouts. And I saw it all around. Made, you know, few small holes to decorate it. And this can be flipped this way. And again, few leftovers, book pages, and just decoration. This is just playing with leftovers and do something interesting with that. And here we've got another opening. It's pocket here. Space for writing. And we've got those two, guest check and just index card. And here is another pocket, that window pocket with this tag. And it's holding with this tab. And another two pockets with that long tag here. And I've got just, yeah, it's just one card. Just this a ledger paper card and this small ephemera on the top, another French ephemera. I think I've got this one from Graphic Fairy website. They've got amazing pictures, really amazing stuff on that Graphic Fairies website. From that other side, you can see my stamping. I did small stamping on those envelopes and again writing space. So this journal, it's really large. It has 10 inches or 10 and a half inches. And here is another layout. I used Tim Holtz, those mixed media dies. It makes like a file folder. So it's pocket here. This is just like decoration. But then it's pocket behind for those two tags. And it's pocket here from that side with this gorgeous girl. And it's pocket behind. Wait. This and a journey card. Oops. And here we've got another clipboard, that holder. So it's in this pocket here, hide it. And it's large pocket behind. And in that pocket behind, I've got again a clipboard and this file folder with lead, not leather, with false leather. It's that piece of paper made in leather look and two ephemeras. So it's in that large pocket here. And we've got opening and frame. This is Tim Holtz, I think decorative frame, it's called vintage cabinet card. Again, writing space here. So many writing spaces, so you can enjoy it fully to write on this journal. Here is just a card with ovals. And here I've got another file folder, that vintage paper. And in that file folder is another index card. Those two index cards. I love ovals. We saying that ovals are birds of knowledge, so I love them so much. And here we've got envelope, large envelope, and in that envelope it's small file folder. It looks like this, and you can slide something inside to keep it like to hold it, like maybe photography holder. It's like this way. So it's in this pocket here, or envelope here. Hey, oh, slide yourself there. And here I've got, this is, I'm not sure where from. I've got this this clear pocket. I'm not sure where from I've got it, but I've got it for a very long time. And I've got here just those two ephemeras and this small advert. And I used that can opener, like a holder, because it looks so so fun. I really like that look. And it's just opening. It has pocket here. It's just, you know, multi-folded paper with pockets. And I used, this is, I think, Martha Stewart Border Punch. If I remember that right, this is Martha Stewart Border Punch. So it's hanging over that envelope like this. And again, papers for writing. And here are just teeny-meeny spots for putting some ephemeras or for some notes. And behind that, we've got another collage. This I tried to do like proper changing something. So it's made from envelope. And I used loads of layers, lots of inks, stencils, those mixed media. I have to hold this to show you. Mixed media dyes, Tim Holtz dyes. So as you can see, it has so many layers, stenciling, stamping, even that rusty effect patina here and here, just like decoration, some laces. And I do have here this small note paper, this beautiful cabinet card. It's holding behind this mini clipboard piece. I'm gonna slide it between those clocks and that clipboard piece. Go there. Yes, like this. And this slide behind. And it's pocket here. And I've got this teeny, meeny, small ticket. Or tuck. Not ticket. And it's pocket behind. And there I've got... This can be also like tuck spot. And I do have that stamping. My own stamping. And small ephemera here. And this tuck. So that's one side. On that other side, I did just stenciling and stamping. And also, you know, my distress inks. This one was, I think, was that? No, that was blue. Yeah, it was blue. And again, writing papers. And here is that other half. It was made from envelope, so here is that other half. It's window, pocket here, again, stamping, stenciling, those dies with rusty patina effect, and it's pocket here, it's pocket behind, so there is so many pockets, like this. Here we've got teeny, mini, small envelope, here, this one, it's like, just like insert, you know. It's here and tuck. I think this was just on my table. It wasn't there, right? And from that other side, it's again just stenciling and using colors. And here we've got again two long pockets with those tucks inside. And those small ephemeras. And this is last page for writing some basics, maybe for putting picture. And a small pocket here. So this is my large writing journal, vintage writing journal. I hope you like it. It was so much fun to create this journal. I hope that I will create lots of more in next year, because I really love to work with those book pages, with that. You can add anything to book pages. That's why I love to work with them, because they are very, very versatile. Is that right word? You can use them in any style, in any design. Book pages are totally awesome. It's like black color. You can mostly use everywhere you want. So book pages are totally same. That's why I love to use them. So this is my sharing for today. Thank you so much for visiting my channel today. Thank you so much for your amazing comments. I love them all. Have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.